Hi, I'm Exact Weather meteorologist Jay Galley, and thanks for logging on to your afternoon video cast. Let's take a look outside. This is our Lee Circle camera, and as you can see, we do have lots of cloud cover. That's because we had all kinds of showers and storms off toward the east. So some high overcast, then some lower clouds developing. And as a result, the National Weather Service still has, in effect, a heat advisory south of Lake Pontchartrain, all the parishes south of Lake Pontchartrain because of the heat and the humidity. Heat indices between 100 and 105, and if you're one of the unfortunate few who still are without power, that'll make it uncomfortable, and the potential for heat illnesses will exist. Checking in on the rivers, all of the rivers now have crested and are beginning to recede. A couple of rivers still experiencing some minor to major flooding. The Pearl River, this is going to be around Bogalusa, experiencing some minor flooding. Also down around this is going to be near Bush, the Bogachita River, still experiencing some minor flooding. But you get further south to near Pearl River, where the Pearl River moves through there, some major flooding still occurring. These rivers will continue to recede over the next day or so. Looking at the satellite and radar imagery, let me draw your attention to this cluster right here. This is moving toward the south. This is going to drop into the Gulf. Not expecting it to be a tropical system, although the National Hurricane Center is giving it a 20% chance of becoming tropical. We'll keep an eye on it. Most of the models, as a matter of fact, all the models right now do not make it tropical, but it will increase our winds and bring us some rain over the next couple of days. Speaking of the tropics, Tropical Storm Leslie right now with 65 mile per hour max sustained winds will move to the north, maybe impacting parts of Nova Scotia before it's all said and done. Is forecast to become a hurricane in the next 12 hours, and Tropical Storm Michael still kind of meandering out there with max sustained winds of 50 miles per hour. Word on Leslie, she is going to move over Bermuda and cause a few problems there. So for today, we'll have a look at the forecast model. There's our area of low pressure. See, it's spinning right here. It will drop down into the Gulf of Mexico. Notice no moisture really wrapping around or intense thunderstorm activity. 1 o'clock this morning, it will be in the Gulf, and it's just going to kind of meander out there. By tomorrow afternoon, looking at more scattered showers and storms being possible. So when you consider this clockwise flow, it will bring some moisture our way, probably enhancing rain chances. It'll create a little bit of wind. And as we get into the 7 o'clock hour on Friday, still in the Gulf of Mexico, this front way up here is going to move down, open up a trough, lift it, and move it out of here. That's the scenario as it's going to play right now. And behind that front, some nice conditions, cooler and drier air. For today, we're going to keep scattered showers and storms in the forecast. Highs basically lower to mid-90s overnight tonight through tomorrow morning. We'll be in the mid-70s to lower 80s, a little muggy, and a 20% chance of rain. Could see one or two spotty showers developing. Here's your 7-day exact cast, 30 to 40% chance through Friday. Then the cold front passes, increasing our rain chances to 60%. Could see a little bit of severe weather as this front passes, but by Sunday, just in time for the Saints game, they're taking on the Redskins. Tailgating will be nice with lower humidity and mild conditions, which will last through Tuesday. I'm Exact Weather meteorologist Jay Galley, and thanks for logging on.